But first, can I just say I'm a bit giddy.
Oh,
feel a bit. I've had too much sleep, obviously. That's the thing. Thank you for having me, ladies.
Oh my goodness, it's so good to have you. We had so much fun yesterday on the meeting. We were all like, yeah,
this yeah, is she's one work. Of us.
We
isn't
like
she?
This. Yeah. So I think we should kick you off, as you alluded to there, with a really good loose women dilemma. It's a new world dilemma. OK. So a friend of a friend of a friend of a friend...
Of a friend.
Just making sure I don't say who they are. Was supposed to be getting married this summer. Yeah. And, of course, there's a lot of brides that had this similar problem, can't do, because of lockdown. And but the bride and maid of honour were incredibly close. But the bride knows is a little bit out of joint, mm-hmm. well, quite a bit, because she really feels that her friend has really neglected her through the summer, hasn't been checking in on her, hasn't been the friend that she thought she mm-hmm. was. And she just feels that she will never get over this, OK? So she wants to sack her
Ooh.
Maid of honour.
Oh,
my
goodness.
What do you think of that?
Ooh.
Listen, I think the interesting thing is it depends on the kind of friendship you have. Because just today, I had a text from my older school friend, the girl I met when I was 11. We haven't spoken all month, right? But our friendship doesn't change whether we talk every day or not. We don't actually. I'm terrible at keeping in touch with my friends. I really am. But they forgive me, they know me, and we're all kind of similar. I think if those two women in question are used to being in each other's lives every week, talking about everything, and all of a sudden that's gone, then I can understand the bride thinking, hang on a minute, I'm quite... Because I think cancelling your wedding is quite a distressing thing to do. Mm. It's the thing you've built up for, it's the thing you've wanted your whole life. You know, the whole thing. And there is a bit of a bridezilla thing going on, isn't there? Becoming a bit obsessed with yourself. And I think that the friend probably should have been a bit of a better friend. So I think you've just got to say, listen, sorry to say this, I think, you know...
She would.
Yeah.
She would without a second thought. Would you? You'd sack a maid of honour, wouldn't you?
Do you know, listen, I'm going to be really honest. I think...
Oh, God, this is never good.
Carol, back me up here. Because the thing is, look, it's your day. It's your day. And if you're not happy with anything, I think you have the right to say, I'm really sorry, I'm going to change things, because nothing is set in stone. And I also believe it's the way you say it. If something has happened between you and your friend, you talk it out and you say, I'm really sorry, but I just don't want it to happen that way.
Yeah.
You know, and that's not... But I don't believe that you should go through your wedding unhappy in any aspect of it.
Carol?
Well, I don't think she should sack her. I mean, she shouldn't have had them in the first place. I think they're a terrible idea. Bridesmaids, like, they always outshine the bride unless you're, you know, deliberately evil and you go and pick your ugliest or, you know, the people that you don't really think look very good. I just think it's a really... I think it's wrong to have bridesmaids.
Well, to even have them. Can I just go one better? Yeah, well, I'll go one better. I know somebody who... had their maid of honour all set in stone and everything, as it would be. Good friends, amazing friends. The friend fell pregnant in between being asked to be maid of honour and the wedding date, and she would have been heavily pregnant at that point. Told this girl, and the bride just was like, yeah, me and my mum have decided we don't want you in the photos being pregnant because I think you'll ruin the photos. And the thing is that then not only did the girl not be the bride, be the chief bridesmaid, she didn't come to the wedding and their friendship ended.
Oh.
So it ended. And I just.
Now I would have ended a friendship with
harsh.
A bride that had told me I couldn't be in the photo.
For being pregnant.
What a sisterhood.
Even I think that's mean.
That's
even
I think would that's actually mean. Have probably said, I'm really sorry, but I don't want you in the photo.
You just sacked her.
Not only because I think for every bride, they have this image of their perfect wedding day. And when she asked the bridesmaid, she wasn't pregnant and things changed.
You mentioned abstain.
Yeah.
Between
fill in this contract and promise me you're not going to have sex.
And that'll be the next thing.
Sarah, that is the shallowest thing I've ever heard in my life. You'd rather sack her.
I promise you,
someone,
in those... In those matters, Carol, I put my hands up. I am so shallow. Yeah. It's
someone,
disgusting.
Why someone was overweight?
But the other thing is with that with this girl, she the way she's kind of said, you know, she hasn't supported me and looked after me, that everybody's needed that kind of help and support during lockdown because everybody, almost everyone, has been having a bit of a hard time. So I think that it's probably the bride that's being a bit selfish. So if I was the bridesmaid, I would quit.
I just think we have to be really careful about judging anyone's behaviour in lockdown, because none of us know what each individual's private hell has been. And a lot of people are pretending they're fine when they're not, so you just don't know.
Well, anyway, another topic I'd like you to discuss is, as a loose woman, one of the key things is you've got to take your kit off and put a swimming costume on, and then you'll be put on a big billboard for the whole world to see. Are you prepared to do it, Ranvi?
Do you know what? I can hear Westminster calling and those big, thick coats and me big boots. I'm really happy, really covered up. And anyway, do you know what? I've actually put a stone on during lockdown, so I might I wouldn't even look at myself in a swimming costume in my own house at the moment. But do you know what I'm calling that? That I'm calling that baby weight that I've gained. Oh. I have gained a new member of my family in the last this week. Look at me.
Oh, he's cockapoo, like my dog.
Yes, look at him.
Beautiful. Oh, he's lovely. What's his name?
His name is Schmizzles. Oh. I know. Come on.
That's not going to work well.
Look at Carol's face. Listen, I was going for King Kenny after Kenny Dalglish, because we're LFC fans in my house. But my son had set his heart on it. And do you know, the other day, it was dead funny. He said, Schmizzles was at home playing around. And Sian came over and he said, Mummy, and Schmizzles is brown like us. And I said, and he's got an unpronounceable name. So he's completely part of the family now.
He fits
lovely.
Right in.
It is lovely.